Good morning, everyone. It is Tuesday. We're on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange with Jim Cramer. All right, Jim, we're awaiting tax reform. Once we get it, do you think it'll be a sell the news type of event?
I think we're getting that already. I think that people should be aware. They should go back to the teach-in that Ken Fisher and I did to get the what it means after tax reform, which is that you tend to get a sell. It's not produced any sort of what I regard as being dispositive evidence, because we've had tax cuts, we've had tax increases. Tax cuts, the market actually did better. But I think you just have to be prepared for the fact that we've had quite a run. We're very overbought. And you know what? Just pick what you, this is your chance. I'm not saying that it is a sell-off that could have great magnitude. I am saying that if you've waited and didn't chase, don't be afraid to start buying. It's something we'll be talking about in our Action Alerts video that I urge people to stay tuned to or join the club.
Yeah, and we're still finding out details of this tax reform bill. So
yeah, I mean, look, I had an interesting discussion with David Faber and Carl Quintanilla. I think that it's going to provide another leg of growth to Florida and Texas. I do believe, sadly, that real estate is going to fall in value in New York. There was someone who tweeted immediately saying, Jim, the expensive housing is going to fall in value too in Texas. I would point out that the property taxes and state taxes are what causes real estate to fall, and they're much lower in Texas than they are in New York and New Jersey.
That's important. All right, meanwhile, Jim, Walmart upgraded at Citigroup. They see a 20% upside. What did you think?
Yeah, look, I thought there was a good piece, and this is the kind of stock that will sell off in a genuine S&P sell-off, like I expect. The greatness of Walmart is it's radically improved. And it may sound like that the research piece is a little, let's say, lacking rigor, because what it says is that it can catch up to Costco and Home Depot. But I think we're getting into a period where it's the big three. And the big three have pricing power, and the big three weren't destroyed by Amazon. And those of us who shop at Walmart notice the change. I don't know who shops at Walmart who's watching, but I do think that that fresh food aisle is very good. They do have a lot of fattening stuff, but, you know, they have stuff for everybody. And it's not like you go to Walmart in order to be able to buy Whole Foods stuff. But they are getting more and more natural and organic. And, you know, look, give them credit. They've got better staff, cleaner stores. They've made real improvements. And those who haven't should visit their Walmart.
And you talked on CNBC about this treasure hunt aspect of Walmart.
Well, Walmart's become more treasure hunt-like, particularly at the front of the store in terms of low price. I mean, Costco was always, when I went there with the great Jim Sinegal, since retired, they had Zegna shirts for the price that a men's store would have to buy the Zegna shirts at. They had beautiful North Face coats. You had to be there. I had to be there to get them. And having at one point had a popcorn company, I can tell you that they brought us in, and then they cut us off, which was one of the reasons why we ended up having to close. But they have different things that you can't get elsewhere.
Meanwhile, General Motors upgraded at RBC.
I thought the piece made sense. General Motors, that was a piece about how downside seems to be capped. The company is moving off of fossil fuels pretty quickly. A lot of optionality, a lot of cash. South America turning. People don't realize how big that is. It was a good piece. Wasn't a great piece. Didn't have something new that we all not thinking. But, you know, people want to buy Tesla off of different companies ordering trucks. I think there's a lot of, excitement about the product line of GM that's not shared by the common stock. And I think that's good.
Is GM cheap in your view?
It sells 6x earnings, yeah. It's cheap.
All right, meanwhile, Jim, what did you make of Darden? Same store sales up 3%.
Well, I've got to do, I'm not on the conference call yet, but I'm a huge believer in Olive Garden. This is a major increase, and it's so big that it calls to mind the fact that there's got to be some sort of trend where people are going out again. Now, as someone who follows the restaurants very closely, the bane of the existence has been takeout. A lot of companies have had to adjust to takeout. It looks like Darden may have adjusted to takeout, but understand that when you don't have people coming in, you don't have liquor. And liquor is a huge part of whatever a restaurant gross margins. But I do think that Darden, I've been in favor of Darden for some time, and I'm just reiterating that I still like Darden. I'm doing the same thing with Carnival Cruise, which is experiential. Darden's not experiential, but Carnival Cruise, when you speak to any of the executives, what they know is that it is the background for Instagram. I understand Facebook coming down. I understand a lot of people are talking about Facebook being yesteryear. And we talked about with Mike Francesi yesterday on Scott Wapner's show. And I don't think it's yesteryear. I still think it's a good business model. But I understand that this is the time when you're looking for year-over-year growth, and you're getting year-over-year growth in a company like a Navistar, like a Caterpillar. Those are the ones that are breaking out, not unlike what we saw in the 80s and 90s, in the 80s with the drug and soft drink companies, and in the 90s with tech companies.
You mentioned a little bit of that in your Real Money column this morning.
Yeah, I think people should go there, because I really kind of talk about the notion of the range and how people don't understand that these stocks had been range-bound and now they're breaking out, and what to do as a trader when you see that.
Yeah, I enjoyed the piece.
Thank you.
Jim, give us a preview of Mad Money tonight.
We have a company called Market Access, and why do I like this? Because it's transparency for bonds. They've done a remarkable job, and I can't wait to speak to them because I also want to ask them about the Bitcoin. I didn't say Bitcoin craze, I said Bitcoin, because I think that there's a lot of money being made, but there could be a lot of money being lost. And I remember the operative term there is when you've made money, you have to ring the register on something. It's not a sin, whether you think it's investing, whether you think it's gambling. Making money is not a sin, but you haven't made it until you take some off the table.
You always say, pigs get slaughtered. All right, Jim, we're going to continue the conversation on actionalertsplus.com. A lot more stocks to talk about. Please join us there.